Welcome back! My name is ballerscuba. This is Video Games Over Time. We are still in 1985. Today, we're going to talk about Gauntlet. The story of Gauntlet takes us back to Atari games. We have talked about Atari games a couple times before. They were responsible for Marble Madness. We last talked about Atari games in our video on Paperboy. For Gauntlet, Atari games turned to Ed Logg. We have talked about Ed Logg before. He has been responsible for Asteroids and Centipede. We last talked about Ed Logg in our video on Millipede. Logg has stated that for Gauntlet, he was inspired by Dungeons & Dragons, which his son played, and the 1984 Atari computer game, Dandy. Dandy was designed by John Howard Palovich and Joel Gluck, and was released through the Atari Program Exchange, or APX. In Dandy, several players can play at once, killing monsters with bows and arrows in search of the exit leading to the next level. Originally called Dungeons, Ed Logg's new game was developed between 1983 and 1985, but had to be renamed to Gauntlet after the name Dungeons was taken by another game. Logg would be joined by programmer Bob Flanagan, artists Sam Comstock, Susan McBride, Alan Murphy, and Will Noble, and composers Hal Cannon and Earl Vickers. The game would use some of Atari's most advanced hardware to date, and it is the first game from Atari Games to feature a voice synthesizer chip. Gauntlet is a dungeon-crawling arcade game. Up to four players can play at a time, playing as Thor, a warrior, Merlin, a wizard, Thyra, a Valkyrie, or Questor, an elf. Each character will have their own strengths and weaknesses, with Thor being the strongest in hand-to-hand combat, Merlin having the most powerful magic, Thyra having the best armor, and Questor being the fastest. The player's goal is to get to the exit in each level. The levels will be filled with items, monsters, and monster generators. The enemies are based on fantasy monsters, including things like ghosts, demons, and sorcerers. While playing, the character's health will drain automatically. If players run out of health, their character will die, but more coins can bring the character back to life, and the player can continue. The game features synthesized speech through a narrator that was voiced by Ernie Fosilius. Fosilius was a Hollywood actor mostly known for parody shorts, but did provide a voice for the Rancor Keeper in Return of the Jedi. Because Gauntlet is designed for up to four players, the arcade cabinet for the game needed to be wider than a typical arcade cabinet. The cabinet would also feature a joystick that could be moved in eight different ways and two buttons, one for fire and one for magic. Atari Games released Gauntlet to British arcades on October 15, 1985. It would then release Gauntlet to North American arcades in November 1985. That is a brief backstory to Gauntlet. With that told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. This is Gauntlet. We get a little title screen. We also get a long demo for this one. So we're going to go through the demo, show all the information that the game has to offer, then we'll go through and play the game ourselves. This is going to be a game that I'm going to struggle with, but we will do what I can. Here's the little demo for us. Well, little. The elf is who they are playing as. They show you how to get points and how to get health and what to do, but I mean, ultimately it's pretty easy to figure out what to do. You use the keys to open the door, you try to get to the exit, you kill monsters along the way, ghosts will do damage to you, so you have to destroy the generators. Once you figure out the generator thing, then you're pretty set. Grunt's not as difficult typically, but we will see as we go forward. There are four characters that you can play. It is a lot more fun with friends. It requires a lot of communication with friends. It takes a lot to kind of describe what's happening. Here's all the potions and stuff. I will not remember all of these, but we will do what we can to make it forward. I haven't fully decided how I'm going to do this as they go through each and every enemy and all their stats. I will point out that the shots to kill and damage to players' health and all that stuff, that is dependent on your character. Those aren't flat things. If you're, like, for instance, the warrior, you can usually take out a level 2 enemy all by with one hit, but then the damage that comes to you is going to be, I believe, a little bit higher than what they show there. So there's a lot that goes into this game. This is kind of a detailed explanation for an arcade game that we haven't seen too much before, but this information is available. I'm not going to bother reading it. I can't honestly read it fast enough, so you kind of just have to glance it over and hope that you remember anything important. But to be honest, none of this is super important until you get to death. Only magic can kill death. You cannot fight death. But there is a thief. They will steal from the richest character, which will be me, because I'll be playing by myself. We'll probably go through a run with each character and see what we can do. There we have all the people responsible. We talked about most of these people. There are a couple extra here as well. They're all responsible for the game. Then we get the high score list. You might recognize Ed on a few of these. That's Ed Log. You might Hal's on some of these. And then we get the title screen again, and so it loops from this point forward. Let's go ahead and get in. I'm going to drop a quarter in for the warrior, and hopefully I have this set up correctly so I can just switch whenever I need to. Let's go ahead and get into the game.
Pressure, 100 points.
And then we got the guy talking to us. Hopefully I won't hear him too much, but eventually he will talk. It's just going to happen. All right.
To open door.
You can open this door. It'll take you further into the dungeon. We're just going to go here because speed is key. Level 2, ghosts must be shot. I think the first time that I get hit, he will say something.
Save potions for later use.
They want me to use the potion to kill all of these. I don't like doing that because it's a pretty easy setup to take them all out like this. And then, finally got hit. Use 8 health. Got hit a couple times there. But like I said, the numbers, they don't always line up the way that you would think. The warrior does have weak magic, but he has strong attack. So those things that I said it would take me 2 times hitting them in order to defeat them, it only takes me 1. That one on the right will take me 2 because it normally takes 3. And my guy hits for 2. So that takes 2 hits. That like that. Food is good. I like food. Treasure's also nice, but I don't care that much about that. I'm more about the food. There we go. And the level of the generator will determine what monster comes out of it. All that good stuff. All right, level 3. Some food can be destroyed. Don't destroy the food. I'm going to try not to let him say it, but he'll probably say it. I'll probably hit one of the foods. It's those whiskey-looking jug things there. Or moonshine or whatever that is.
Remember, don't shoot food.
There we go. It's honestly my favorite thing that he says in the game, so I'm not too upset that he said it. But he did say it. All right, let's do what we can here. Destroy the things. There's a lot of them here. Yeah, it takes so much to destroy it when you're hand-to-hand. You can just kind of run into things and destroy them, but it's a lot easier to throw things, at least in my mind. It is. Okay. There. Okay. We're down to 400 health. I'll probably put 2 quarters in for each one that we're doing. Just to get a fair sense of how they work and all that kind of stuff. Still have a spare key. Fight hand to hand by running into grunts. Once again, not super recommended. Let's go for it. Magic potions affect everything on screen. I would say normally kill, but that is not true, right? They basically give you one hit of however strong your magic is, and we have weak magic, which means that everything only hits once. Okay. And now you can see why they call it Gauntlet. It really is just a gauntlet of enemies heading your way. And the monster generators do not help things.
Need food, bad warrior.
Okay. There's some food that'll last you at least a little bit. These are strong grunts. Just keep throwing, and eventually things will die. Now, there is an auto fire in this, but it's very slow. That's how slow the auto fire is. I never use it. Okay. Down to 245. We might be able to make it off this floor. But this will probably be the floor that does me in. Because they don't give you a lot of food here. Alright, you notice that my health is constantly going down. There's some food. I destroyed it.
Warrior,
I thought I had grabbed it. Okay, is there food over here? You can't destroy treasure, but there's honestly times I wish it would. Okay, let's put in another quarter. There we go. It's just instantly 600 health. It's a lot easier to do in this app that I have than it would be with, like, an actual arcade, because then you have to, like, bend down, drop the quarter, all that kind of stuff. I just have to hit a button. Okay. So many enemies. This is why it's more fun with, you know, four people, because then you have, like, four people firing at it, you know, if things are going well for you. But if you have people that don't know what they're doing or don't really pay attention that much, then it can be a lot harder. I think I went the wrong way. Jeez, so many enemies. I feel like I'm not even making progress here. All right, let's try to make it forward through this. This might be a dumb idea. Try to line up there. Trying to destroy that. And that seems like a stupid thing for me to do. So this whole path here was a stupid thing for me to do. All right, on to level 5. Beware the demons which shoot you. What about the demons that don't shoot me? Are they all right? I should only beware the ones that shoot me. That's what I interpreted out of that. Not worth it. Oh, there's food over there, though. Yeah. Okay. And that was my last potion. God, you guys can shoot through that. That's not nice. Just kill them. Okay.
Beware the demons.
Beware the demons, but now we're sorcerers I need to beware of.
Ooh.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, every time one of the enemies gets hit, one of your players gets hit by a new enemy, then you get a new little thing of dialogue.
Ooh. Warrior, your life force is running out.
I'm aware how bad I am. You don't need to remind me. But you can't hit the sorcerers while they're invisible. But yeah, there's food.
Warrior is about to die.
Yeah, they give them names, but then they don't say it in the game. Did I already pass the way out? I think I did. Alright, so I got number one score as a warrior, so that I feel like that didn't take much. But I'll go ahead and accept it. We'll put a quarter in for Valkyrie. And then once the timer runs out, we'll start over. I was hoping to get that food down there and the key and all that kind of stuff. I don't have the levels memorized by any means, but we'll go through one round with each person. Like I said, two quarters. Okay. Now, pretty much the same setup, except hers goes a little bit faster.
Ouch.
I like the better. Ouch. Alright, let's head down here. She should have, I believe, the highest armor rating. Ghosts must be shot, which means I can't run into ghosts.
Save potions for later use.
Yeah, she's got a stronger one, so we should be good there. And then... up! Yeah, I'm not as good with the Valkyrie all of a sudden. Like... there we go. Grab all of that. But yeah, now these guys take two hits, so I don't like the Valkyrie as much. Being a little bit faster doesn't help that much if I can't do as much damage. Being faster but takes less hits, but it takes longer to kill all of these. If it takes double the time to kill enemies, then is it really worthwhile to have a little bit less damage done to me? I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how it pans out at the end. Maybe I can just kind of avoid enemies doing this.
Ouch.
And yet, like, hand to hand.
Remember, don't shoot food.
I'll try to remember that. I saw it. Like, I saw it as I was doing that. I'm like, oh, well, I destroyed that food. All right, let's try to just motor through this. All right. There we go. That'll give me enough to make it out of here. There we go. Fight hand to hand by running into grunts. Or, hear me out, I could shoot them because that's what my character does best. But when it comes to level 2 grunts, then things might get a little bit more difficult for me. Alright. Yeah, having two hits is... like, I'm so used to the warrior. It's usually what I play. It's kind of the basic one. Going different requires a little bit more skill and strategy, which I don't have. How about I try running forward and shooting? How's that for a strategy? Yeah, these guys taking three hits is bad for me.
No.
Yeah, I'm aware. But they're spawning so fast.
No.
Valkyrie needs food.
All right. There's your food. Not that it's going to help you too much, but now I'm out of potions. There's that food. Yeah, it's just... okay. there's not too much I can do here. I'm hitting the button as fast as I can, but...
ow.
There goes, like, all my health. Really does need multiple players. So what I might be able to do, I'll try it, because I kind of have a setup so that I have all the characters on the same controls. So maybe I can like bring all four characters in at once and just control them all and be a nightmare to control. But hey, lots of damage.
Ow.
I'll destroy all the food. Okay. Yeah, we're going to avoid a lot of this. I feel like I'm doing worse with the Valkyrie than I was with the warrior. I destroyed the food again. It feels like I'm playing worse, but actually I think my health is a little bit better than it was with the warrior at this point, wasn't it? Wasn't I down to like 100 or so? I think I was. No. Maybe we're doing better. And now my controller's starting to squeak. That's not good. I think at this point, though, I used the magic. And I don't have that availability this time. Yeah, I'm not making it through this. The grunts absolutely destroy me.
Ow.
I'm going as fast as I can, but, like, there's just too much. It literally is a gauntlet. That's kind of the point. All right, she's dead. I got number 8, so no, not as good with the Valkyrie as I am the warrior. But if you're playing single player, it kind of makes sense for that to work. All right, we'll put something in for the wizard. And once again, we'll start from scratch, kind of just compare apples to apples. Now, if memory serves me right, like the wizard and the elf can't destroy monster generators? That can't be true, but that's what I've been told. So we'll test that out. I feel like it can't be true.
Welcome.
All right, here comes the wizard. What was that? All right.
They need to open door.
Let's drop down here. Okay, you gotta go. For an old man, you sure do move fast.
Save potions for later use.
Yeah, he's really strong with the magic, so we'll save that for when it's like really difficult. Okay. He also fires very quickly. I like that. I think he fires faster than the Valkyrie does. Yeah, easily. Okay. Done. I think I get hit when that sound happens. I think it's only one per hit, though? Yeah, it's only one. Okay. So far, so good. The wizard might not be too bad for me, but we'll see what happens as I keep going. Right? No, I think I'm doing two. Because those things took two hits, and those were max level. Alright. Some food can be destroyed. I am aware, I will try not to, but he's gonna say it. Try not to shoot food. I'm not sure I will ever get used to that. He's good at the monster generators.
Oh.
That might be better long term. Alright, let's try to make a break for it. Use that and oh, I destroyed the monster generators on the screen too. Just on the screen though, keep that in mind. Alright, a little less than 400. Yeah, we're not doing hand to hand with the wizard ever. Not if I can help it. I said as I could not help it. I probably could have, but I didn't. 5 points, yeah. Alright, so this is what did me in as the Valkyrie. We'll see what I do with the wizard. Because he's so quick at destroying the generators, though, maybe that will help. Would also help if I, you know, picked up the food instead of shot it. I haven't gotten him to say don't destroy food, but he will. Come on, everybody in there. Yeah, okay.
Remember, don't shoot food.
Don't shoot food. That was my last potion, but man, was it I was just kind of stuck. Yeah.
Your life force is running out.
About the same spot it was for Valkyrie for me. Alright, we're getting close to the end here, but I can put in a quarter. Right? I haven't put in a quarter for him yet. Alright, let's do that now. Okay. Nice. So it was worthwhile to go over there. Just that side. But I wouldn't have known that if it wasn't for the wizard. Because the wizard is very good at destroying things. Oh, this does not look good for me at all. He's a distance guy. You're not letting me get distance. Okay. I think I was just hitting the treasure chest there. I'm not sure, but I wasn't dealing any damage, that's for sure. Okay. The wizard's, I think, my best so far. Until here. I need more magic. Yeah, you would need a lot of communication if you're going to do this multiplayer as well. You would need, like, okay, the wizard is the one that does this. The wizard picks up the potions, all that. Who needs other things? All right, beware the demons, which will shoot you. Yes, it is worth it. Okay. Hit him! 300, huh? I still think I'm doing the best that I have with him. It's not much I can do about them shooting fireballs at me, though. Okay, I want that food as well. Faster the better. Okay, let's use that. Oh, they can destroy themselves. Okay, down there we go. Level 6, 291 health. I think I wanted to go this way before, so. For whatever reason, I did not see that there, that generator. I just saw it as part of, like, the background or whatever. Yeah, okay. So wizard about the same as the warrior overall. Yeah, about the same. Apparently, my point score goes way down when I get hit, doesn't it? I think that's one of the issues. Okay, so then that's the elf. Yeah, we'll wait because you, of course, if I hit the button here, it'll just start me over here. We'll do one more round and then we'll try something crazy with all of them. You know, give you a sense of what it's like playing as all the different characters, even though like they're different, but they're not that different, you know?
Welcome. 100 points.
He is the fastest. I think he has the fastest shot as well. No sound whatsoever. Oh, there was something. He squeaked. He squeaked. All right, ghosts must be shot. He's so fast.
Save potions for later use.
All right. Let's hit that and then. Because, yeah, I can only have one shot on screen at a time. So, like, when I do that, it's a lot faster, but normally you can't tell too much. It does make a little sound every time I hit it, doesn't it? Or I shoot, doesn't he? Yeah, we'll have to see about his magic. I have a feeling that it's only going to be like the first level, just one damage of magic So I'm trying not to use it right now. How am I not hit it? Yeah, hit the generator. Thank you. I think it's just one damage per arrow, but they can go so fast. 523. So far, so good, but we'll see here. All right. Wow, okay. And I think the elf's going to be my favorite. Let's just go for it. Get out of there. Yeah, I'm never going to fight hand-to-hand with the elf if I can help it. Because I think that the potion did 2 damage as opposed to just like 1 hit. Yeah, he's a little too unwieldy, actually, because now I can't, like, position him the way that I want. Come on. Oh, that's so many. All right. Boom. Hit the button. Yeah, 2. It does 2. So he does 1 attack, 2 magic. Fair enough, and he's fast. I'm making it further than I have without dropping a quarter in. Is running out. About the same as the wizard, maybe a little bit further. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do it after this. All right, there you go. How you're supposed to do that while you're at the arcade cabinet, I'm not entirely sure. Take a quarter out of your pocket and find the slot all the while mashing the attack button. Like, for me, like I said, it's just a button and it's still like, oh, I'm not sure I'm doing it right. Hit him! He's a little unwieldy. He likes to just, like, point the wrong direction. Okay, so I do want to go that way. And firing the shot doesn't matter too much when I have distance. The shot speed doesn't, because you can only have the one on screen at a time. The grunts, the damn grunts. Yeah, he's still a little hard to control for me. So much damage.
Help. Need food.
Yeah, I tried to get out of there as fast as I could. So, not the worst. Not the best, though, for me. All right, I at least survive. I need to be more defensive when they have shots like that, but it's really hard. Yeah, I can't even make it. Nope, not gonna make it. Maybe. I did. Hooray. Is there more?
Elf is about to die.
Elf is about to die. I don't have another potion or anything. Yeah. I can try all I want. I'm trying to hit the spawner, but all right. There we go. All right. So that is the end of that. Let's see if I can move on from here. Drop another quarter into all of them. And hit the button.
Welcome.
All right. It worked.
Do not hurt other players yet.
Okay. unwieldy party go.
Treasure, 100 points.
Doing as much damage as I can here. So this is something of what it would look like if everybody played at once. How? Getting through spaces like that's going to be very difficult with all my people on the same controls. Okay. Everybody out. The elf's going to have so much health compared to everybody. No! Okay, you guys through there. You through there. No, this is terrible. Okay, we got everybody through that one, and now through that one. Okay. And now you can see how it's better for four people, even with me not being able to control anything. All right, let's drop quarters in for everybody. Okay, where are we going? Yet, once again, anytime anybody gets hit by a new... Okay, we're all that for treasure. Okay, up. Okay. Elf is not doing well over there, but we'll see what we can do with them. Okay, everybody bunched up again? Let's go this way. Try to get bunched up again. With everybody going different speeds, it's very hard to control. Don't shoot food! Told you guys I would destroy food, didn't I? Okay, let's go... I guess this way. I never made it through this level, so I don't know where I'm going yet.
Don't shoot the potion.
Shooting the potion has a lesser effect. I'm not sure who shot it. I'm gonna say it's the elf. Technically, I want the Valkyrie to get that. Hey, that worked out. Okay, on to level 7. Okay. Health for everybody. Let's go.
Oh.
Don't shoot food. I keep shooting the food. That is death over there. I need you up here as well. That is death. Okay, well, I shot the potion, which did the damage. Honestly, didn't know you could even shoot potions like that. Okay. There's the exit. We'll take it. Down to level 8. Quarters. I think that hit everybody. Thank you. Very valuable pieces of information. This is just like we're still in single digit levels. Like it goes on for a while, this game. All right, this way. Okay, there's the exit. I'm out of keys. They can spawn in this, but I can't make it out of this. Where are we going? And we got the lobbers, they're lobbing. And then I believe that's a warp zone.
Ow!
Save potions for later use.
Nope, now. How about now? Okay, we got a key.
To open door.
Unclear where to go from here. Huh. Oh, there's some monsters.
Oh.
That is death. Death did go away there. Okay, get out. Get out of there. Come on. We're gonna have to find a did I transport back to where I was? I did. Okay. It loops, doesn't it? It does. That's my issue here. Okay. There's no other one on screen for me to warp to. This is gonna be a problem. Okay. Everybody on this side. Then... here, I guess? I feel like that's the same one that I've been doing. Okay, we good. Everybody back together. Yeah, it's all the same one. I don't see any other place for me to transport to, though. Quickly running out of health. Quarters. Every time it does that, just keep in mind that cost me a dollar.
Trap make wall disappear.
What trap? What wall? How do I get up there? I didn't see anything. No. There we go. Okay. No! Wait, why did he spawn down there? Okay. If I keep you there... No. How do I... No! How are two of them where I want them to be and two not? Am I going to have to do this like two at a time?
Valkyrie now has extra shot speed.
Alright, well there's something I guess. Go Valkyrie. Even having two players in one of these is so much better than trying to do this solo. I want that health. No, I think that's the exit right there, too. I'm just going to have to move on. All right, that's probably enough Gauntlet for today. That is the game played, and with the game played, let's talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, I had fun playing Gauntlet to a certain extent. The game is fun, but it is also frustrating, and it's frustrating for me because I want to make it further in the game, and I feel that the game is designed that no matter how many characters, how many players you have kind of going at once, it's kind of designed to make you feed quarters into the machine. It's just designed that you're not going to be able to play it all the way through without feeding quarters into it. If you're playing by yourself, you're going to be overwhelmed by enemies, have to drop quarters in. If you're playing with four people, there's not enough food to go around to sustain it. Not everybody's going to be able to get a thing of food every 100 seconds. That's just kind of how the game is designed. That's just kind of from the outside. Maybe if you're able to find four people that are really good at the game, they can blast through it. Not, maybe I'm wrong, and they can get food fast enough to be able to get through the levels fast enough to get the food that they need. But from my perspective right now, it just feels like it's designed to eat quarters. So I wasn't able to make it super far in the game playing by myself. I was able to make it to about levels 5 or 6, depending on the character that I was playing. I wanted more potions. I wanted more things kind of along the way. I would think that this game would be better for my particular tastes if it was a computer game and then a lot easier. Not necessarily easier in terms of difficulty, really, just in terms of let me make it further. Which I guess is easier. It's not necessarily a difficult game. You're just overwhelmed by the odds. Just button mashing and hoping that you kind of make it through it. It just feels like a war of attrition more than anything else. So ultimately, it is fun, but it's only fun for me in short bursts because of just this aspect of you're constantly losing. And that's how it felt playing the game. So ultimately I had fun with it, but there is that aspect to it. I think that the sound to the game is good. I don't think it's particularly great. I think it's kind of silly, some of the things that he says and things like that, but it's a little weird looking at it from a modern perspective, the sound. It just doesn't come across quite the same way that I think it did in 1985 anymore. The graphics, I feel, are pretty good to basic. They're nothing particularly special, but there's nothing bad about them. I don't think they've aged poorly or anything like that. I just don't think that they were that fantastic at the time either. In terms of the gameplay, it's a button masher. There's no way around it. You just have to constantly smash the button. Even if you get four people together, you're likely just going to all be smashing the buttons, trying to kill as many enemies as you can. And that does get tedious after a while. It's hard to find people today that like that kind of style of game of just you're overwhelmed by enemies, defeat as much as you can, and you're going to lose over time, kind of no matter what. Let's see how far you make it. It's not a gameplay style that has aged particularly well, but if you're okay with that, then this is a game for you. If you want to get people together and kind of laugh and get frustrated together, then this might be a game for you as well. But ultimately, I would think that this game is better served by watching somebody play it than actually playing it yourself if you are new to video games. But if you are interested in the history of dungeon crawlers and the history of arcade games and you like fantasy settings, this game does have something to offer for you. And then once you get in once or twice, you can see if you want to keep going, because it really is just going to be more of the same the longer that you get into it. And then of course, with my wonky setup with the four players, I wasn't able to make it further despite my efforts with the teleporters, but I was able to clear the room, just couldn't get everybody into the spot where I needed them to go in order to win. And that also was frustrating, so that might be clouding my judgment a bit, but Overall, it's a good game. It's just not necessarily one of my personal favorites, but I can see how people would like this. And then, of course, when you add the multiplayer aspect, you can, of course, have fun with friends. That doesn't really take into account a lot of the gameplay and the quality of the game, or the quality of your friends. And that's kind of hard to account for, at least for me. But once again, worth checking out. Maybe dropping a quarter or two into, but not necessarily dedicating a lot of time to. And that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, Gauntlet proved to be very successful. In the United States, Gauntlet would top the sales charts. It would become one of the highest earning cabinets of 1986, selling over 7,800 units. The game would be released by Namco to Japanese arcades starting in February 1986. There, it would become one of the highest grossing arcade cabinets of 1986 as well. The critics were also positive about the game, praising the game's action and gameplay. As time has gone on, the game would retain its positive reputation. Gauntlet will occasionally make lists of best video games of all time. The game was not without controversy, however. John Palevich, the creator of Dandy, threatened to sue Atari Games, stating that Gauntlet used his original concept for Dandy without his permission. This would be settled without lawyers, with Atari Games allegedly giving Palevich a Gauntlet arcade machine. Gauntlet would see ports and sequels. We will keep an eye on these as we continue. As for Atari Games, the success of Gauntlet would keep the company in the video game industry. We will be hearing from Atari Games again. As for Ed Logg, the veteran video game developer would continue to create video games. We will hear from Ed Logg in the future as well. That will do it for the story of Gauntlet for now. My name is Baller Scuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we see it again.